there. People with a great self-esteem appear to have a magical and happy life. We ought to admire people who seem to be self-assured and confident in themselves. This gets some people to try and fake it, while others act in pride and think that being conceited or arrogant shows confidence. But it never really works like that. I am Catherine Gaho from SBU Research. Thank you for tuning into my channel, Elevators, where we offer elevating and empowering messages to help you grow in life, career, and business. In this video, I will talk about why we all need to work to develop a healthy self-esteem. I will also highlight 8 tips to boost self-esteem. Do like this video and stay with me to the end so that you can know the why and how. I believe that one of the true markers of a healthy self-esteem is self-acceptance. To be self-aware and to accept yourself as you are. It's how well you value yourself, how important you think you are to yourself. It's about how you see yourself more than how others see you. People with a healthy self-esteem are unlikely to do the common sabotage that we see a lot these days. Self-esteem is not about whether others will like you, but that you will be okay even if they don't. Self-esteem is not about arrogance or bragging. It's also not about faking it or acting out. A healthy self-esteem is about understanding the real you and seeing yourself in a realistic and positive way. It's not about perfection, but more about recognizing that we are all unique and valuable in our own ways, and no one is perfect. I like what Blake Lively said, that the most beautiful thing you can wear is self-confidence. A person with a healthy self-esteem is unlikely to be caught up in some of the illegal and dangerous actions that we see some people go down for because of chest thumping, peer influence, or because of extreme personal insecurity. Or like what we see on programs like Crime and Investigation, where some women commit serious crimes for their men and end up going to jail for life, leaving their families crying. We also see young men and women being pushed by manipulative friends and end up committing offenses that proceed to change their whole lives. And they are doing this just to feel like they fit in, that they are welcome to belong to this group, or that they are worthy. Some of these crimes of passion, or what I hear these days being called intimate partner crimes that have become very common, have a link to low self-esteem. You only need to listen to the radio or watch TV programs as they interview these prisoners, and you see the issues of low self-esteem playing out. Even in less serious situations, people can end up losing their jobs, losing income or important relationships because of bad decisions and choices, with the underlying issue being low self-esteem. In fact, some research has found a link between low self-esteem and some of these issues. Now, low self-esteem also makes people become oversensitive. Sometimes they can lack even a sense of humor, and they feel like they are being targeted by every innocent joke. This interferes with their ability to build and maintain healthy and respectful relationships, which further feeds the low self-esteem with feelings like nobody likes me, nobody cares about me, and the like. Let me acknowledge that it's not always easy to raise your self-esteem. As Ralph Waldo Emerson put it, to be yourself in a world that is constantly trying to make you something else is the greatest accomplishment. Now to the 8 tips for boosting self-esteem. First, identify and keep a list of positive things about yourself that you are grateful about. As Oprah Winfrey put it, be thankful for what you have. You will end up having more. Or as Charlie Brown said, keep looking up. Second, set realistic standards for yourself. You do this by recognizing that you have a right to be here in your full unique self and to avoid comparing yourself with others. As Mark Twain said, comparison is the death of joy. In my video on joy and enthusiasm, I talk a lot about how to harness just the simple things to be able to achieve greater sense of fulfillment, which is a major part of building your self-esteem. Third, use the words, I am, with care. I learned this from Joel Osteen. Joel Osteen is a major thinker and speaker around this question of how we use the words, I am. What do you say behind those words? And he says that we should say things like, I am worthy, I am kind, I am good enough, I am grateful, I am blessed, and the like. That is, whatever positive things you believe about yourself, you can add after I am. Four, focus on your strength. Everyone has something that works for them. Meditate on your strengths, because whatever you focus your attention on tends to grow. I believe that what you think most about will expand in your mind and be magnified in your life. So you need to choose wisely. Keep gemstones in your mental jewelry box. Do not keep skeletons in your wardrobe, so to say. Fifth, take self-care seriously. When you take great care of yourself, you become a better person for others. I've heard it said that when you feel good about yourself, you tend to treat others even better. So enjoy self-care. Take care of yourself. Why should you work so hard and then feel guilty spending some money on your self-care? Self-care is not self-indulgence. It's an act of safeguarding your well-being. Sixth, work on your look and feel. While accepting yourself as you are, you have the responsibility to work to enhance your appearance through proper grooming, regular body and mind care, good oral care, and so on. And this will make you feel good too. I believe that anyone over 20 is responsible for how they look. According to Catherine Hakim, a controversial British sociologist who wrote a book on the power of attraction, it pays to work on your look and feel. Her research found that working on how you look adds value to your work and your life, and may even add value to your income. Catherine Hakim did controversial research and came up with this concept called erotic capital. That's why I mentioned the issue of controversy around her. But that does not discount the value of this point of working to look your best. Seventh, watch your mental diet. This is one of my major beliefs. I have a video on how to watch your mental diet. You can look for it in this channel. Take care of what you feed your mind. The books you read, the movies you watch, and the thoughts you harbor in your mind, they all impact your self-esteem. To learn more about this, watch my video on this channel titled Why You Should Watch Your Mental Diet. You'd also need to invest in spending more time with people who hold you well and who listen to your opinions and who encourage and inspire you. Forgive yourself when your plans do not work. Use your mistakes to learn from failures. Don't beat yourself up. Recognize that failure is temporary. You never fail until you stop trying. Or as Winston Churchill put it, success is going from failure to failure without losing your enthusiasm. Number eight, be open to start new things. Starting a new thing helps you overcome self-doubt, and over time, it helps you to build self-assurance and confidence. Learning a new skill is good for your self-esteem. This could mean taking up a new sport, learning a new language, you know, speaking in public, and things like that. With time, as your confidence muscle improves, you can also decide that you will deal with one of your greatest fears. One of the things I've learned about how to boost your confidence is to prepare greatly. Prepare more, and you will find yourself having more confidence. And again, learn to celebrate your small wins, and over time, you will have more wins. To sum up, my tips to boost your self-esteem are: 1, keep a list of positive things about yourself. 2, set realistic standards for yourself. 3, use the words I am with care. And 4, focus on your strengths. 5, take self-care seriously. Sixth, work on your look and feel. Seventh, watch your mental diet. And eighth, to be open to start new things. Start a new thing. Thank you so much for staying with me. Do like this video and share it with other people who you think might benefit from it. Thank you and best wishes as you work to boost your self-esteem. We all need to boost our self-esteem, and we all need to elevate our mindset at this time.